in a patient with advanced Parkinson's disease that tend to lose their dopamine neurons. So when you give them levodopa, which is the medication to treat Parkinson's disease, the effect of the medication does not last well into the next dose. So for example, if the patient is taking the dose 3 times a day in the early part of the disease, they may require to take it 4 or 5 times a day. So you take the medicine, it doesn't last into the next dose. That's called wearing off or motor fluctuations. There are extended and controlled release formulations of levodopa. There is an extended release formulation called Rytary. The other medications that can be used to provide more on time are medications that inhibit some of the enzymes that would break down dopamine. So these are monoamine oxidase B inhibitors such as prasugrel and cefenamide. There is also an enzyme called COMT. So COMT inhibitors are entacapone, talcapone, and opicapone. There is a medication that's called estradefylin or Nurians. These are adjunct therapies. There are also rescue or add-on therapies. These are sublingual apomorphine. It's a dopamine agonist. There's also a subcutaneous formulation of apomorphine. We do not have the continuous apomorphine pump yet in America. And then last but not the least is a levodopa inhaler that's called Inbrija. There is a medication called amantadine, which comes in immediate release formulation, but it also comes in an extended release formulation that's called Gocovri, and there's another one called Osmolex. This is a medication that we use for treatment of dyskinesias. Because, you know, there aren't really great medical therapies other than DBS. Dyskinesias are involuntary movements, and they are the combination of side effect of medication and progression of Parkinson's disease. What we may need to do is we may need to reduce the individual dose of levodopa, but that can also result in, you know, worsening of their Parkinsonism. You want to ensure, firstly, that the patient has regular bowel movements. Because in Parkinson's disease, everything is slow. So transit through the bowel is slow. So if they have constipation, we help them to have a regular bowel movement every day. They need to take the medicine on an empty stomach with a full 8 to 10 ounces water. And they need to separate their meals and medications by at least an hour. This ensures that they are absorbing almost 90% of the medication that they take.